Good afternoon, everyone. Good
Everyone.
afternoon, Miss Leslie.
Good
Yan.
afternoon.
Pwede ba kami makahingi muna ng heart sa inyo, guys? Yan, dami, ang dami. So, welcome sa 200 na attendees and counting, nadadagdagan pa. Ayan, ang daming heart.
Dami.
Masabog na naman. So, ayun, kamusta naman ang lahat? Kamusta ang inyong Sabado, ang inyong week? Because napakainit pa rin sa Pilipinas. Buti na
Oo.
lang nandito ako ngayon sa New Zealand. In New Zealand.
Sana all.
Joke lang, ma'am. Joke lang, ma'am. Dito po tayo sa Pilipinas at napakainit. So, ayun, ma'am. Hindi ko napapatagalin. Welcome sa aming free webinar every Saturday, every week to. And ngayon, meron na naman tayong bagong webinar. And isa sa mga pinakamagaling na speaker yung mag-talk na naman. And bago ang lahat, gusto namin magpakilala. Vaim Philippines is one of the leading agency here in the Philippines. No? Nagtitailor kami ng mga virtual assistant. Nagkikater kami ng mga aspiring and yung mga may experience na virtual assistant. Sa mga aspiring, nagtuturo kami ng mga free webinar kagaya nito kung ano ba yung papasukin yung career as a virtual assistant. Kung ano ba yung kakaharapin nilang work. Yan. So, ino-open namin yung mga aspiring na kagaya nyo na nandito lahat. Even though yung mga meron ng experience, mas tine-tailor pa natin sila, mas magiging competent sila. Kasi napakarami ng VAs, pero hindi naman ganun ka-competent. So, nandito yung Vaim Philippines para tulungan namin kayo maging competent sa inyong ginagawa. And with that, marami kayong magiging client na pwede kayong maging ma-acquire. Yan. So, yun, Miss Les. And konting house rules lang. If mayroon po silang mga question and gusto itanong, pero po tayo Q&A sa baba. Ayan, kung makikita nyo. You can, hello, good afternoon. Meron lang po. Pwede po kayo mag-type lang sa baba and sasagutin ng ating speaker yan. Ayan, sasagutin ng speaker natin yan at the end of the webinar. And stay tuned until the end kasi magbibigay kami ng free certificate. And bibigyan namin yung form kung saan kayo magkapag-sign up. So kapag hindi nyo po tinapos yung webinar, wala po kayong matatanggap na certificate. So, yun. Miss Les?
Yes, guys. Stay until the end of our webinar. Kasi sayang naman, libre na, diba? And matututunan pa natin kung paano maging isang virtual assistant sa iba't ibang klaseng mga niche. So, guys, hello. Welcome again. This is Vaim Philippines free webinar. So, pwede mo mag-heart yung mga first-timers. First time! Heart-heart naman dyan! Ayan, dami pa rin first time! Pang ilan na
Madami
natin
pa din
to,
po.
Pero dami pa rin talagang gustong maging virtual assistant. Ayun, no? Grabe. Daming heart. Eh, pwede bang mag-like naman yung mga, ano, pang fifth na nila, or mga pang second, pang third? Like nyo naman. Ayun, no?
Ang dami rin, ma'am.
Mga since day one yan, sir.
Ang dami, oh.
Ay, ang dami. Hello guys, welcome back again dito sa ating free webinar. Napakarami po nating matututunan. So, i-ready nyo na po yung mga notes nyo, yung mga notebook nyo. Kung meron kayong mga questions na gustong ibato sa ating speaker later, i-note nyo lang yan and i-type nyo lang sa Q&A natin later. So, don't worry, nakikita namin lahat ng messages nyo po. It's just ang panelists lang po ang makakakita nun. So, kung feeling nyo hindi nakikita, nakikita namin yan, guys. So, type in your questions kung meron kayong mga gustong itanong. So, wag na nating patagalin, Sir Mark. I-welcome na natin yung speaker natin for today na ang pag-uusapan is about conversion rate optimization. So, napakagandang topic. Sobrang interesting. At talagang marami tayong matututunan at madadagdagan pa yung ating knowledge. So, yung ating speaker for today po ay meron ng 8 years experience sa marketing industry. So, imagine that experience. Sobrang tindi po nun at napakarami na niyang maishishare sa atin. And isa rin po siya sa CEO at owner ng Googler Media Pro. So, what is that business? Mamaya i-explain po niya at i-discuss niya. Kaya, guys, samahan niyo po akong i-welcome yung ating speaker for today. Hindi po siya magsasalita hanggat walang palakpak at heart. Let us welcome Sir Jeff Glur. Come on, guys! Welcome, sir!
Thank you for that introduction. So, let me just give you a minute. Okay.
Go on, sir. Ang daming palakpak po.
Wow. Hi guys, thank you everyone. So, yun, ang daming joiners. Almost 248 participants. So, thank you. And in behalf of Bing, thank you for this opportunity to conduct this webinar, this training series for conversion rate optimization. So, I would like to welcome everyone here na nag-join. So, I hope marami tayong matutunan na inputs regarding this topic that can help you with your career path journey. With also those aspiring virtual assistant, you know. So, okay, so can we proceed now to the actual lessons?
Sure, sir. Are you ready?
Ah, yes. So, guys, ready na ba kayo?
Go ahead,
thumbs
sir.
Up tayo. Thumbs up tayo dyan para mag-proceed. Okay. So, let me just share my screen. Okay.
Yan, sir. Visible naman po, sir. Paano na lang po
Okay na
tayo,
ba
no?
siya?
Full screen na lang po.
Okay. Ayan.
Yan.
So,
Thank you, sir.
guys. Okay, so we could start now with this topic. Again, thank you for that introduction. So, just to give you a quick overview about my background. So, it's correct. I have almost 8 years experience in the marketing industry. But prior to that, I have almost 13 years experience working remotely. So, imagine 13 years home-based na ako. So, working at the comfort out of my own home. So, yon. So, marami siguro sa inyo dito galing sa corporate who wants to transition into online like work from home. So, marami sa inyo siguro dito are choosing what niche that you want to pursue for online jobs or for work from home. So, I think this is a good topic that we can discuss with. So, CRO, anyone here are familiar with this term? Just raise your hands if you're familiar with conversion rate optimization. Okay. So, basically, medyo unique tong niche na to. It's not something like, kasi more on, ano tayo eh, most of you probably familiar tayo sa SEO. So, meron ba ditong familiar na with SEO or okay, very good. So, SEO and okay. So, more of you are familiar with SEO. Okay, that's good. So, CRO and SEO are totally different but they are collaboratively connected somehow, no? So, ang ituturo natin dito with our lesson summary is introduction to CRO, the CRO process. So, ano yung process involves in creating a CRO, key metrics and goals, so which is important factors, ano yung dapat natin tinitingnan when we are conducting a CRO, user experience and CRO, their connection. So, user experience more on UX, UI, maybe some of you are familiar with this terminology. We will not discuss it as a user and UX UI because it's a different topic, but the connection between the two, we will discuss that. A/B split testing or landing page optimization. So, psychology of conversion. So, this is, I think, pinaka-important when it comes to CRO. And then, some CRO tools and technologies that we can use for implementing conversion rate optimization. Okay. So, as I said earlier, CRO and SEO are two distinct but complementary strategies. So, ang CRO is focused more on driving sales, convert visitors into customers, and increases conversions. While SEO, it promotes visibility, boosts website traffic, and find prospects. So, siguro sa mga SEO dito, so some of you perhaps are a good SEO specialist or you bring a lot of traffic in a particular website, which is really good. But what CRO does is it helps you to convert those traffic into conversion into actual results. So, sabi ko nga sa mga client namin, it doesn't matter how many traffic meron sa website mo. What matters is how many of those visitors converts. Ilang percent ang na-converts. Sometimes, as an SEO, Our goal is to find a related keywords. So find some keywords that most competitors are using. So our focus are more on SERP, paano mapaparang sa first page. But sometimes we can see that even though ang dami ng taas na ng ano natin, website traffic natin, makikita natin into actual conversion, konti ang nag-click if you're familiar with Google Analytics. So, makikita natin doon na minsan ang results is napakalayo sa mismong traffic natin. Sometimes, ang taas ng bounce rate. So, we will discuss that terminology later on for some of you na not familiar pa. So, to proceed, so, what is ERO? So, this is based from HubSpot. If you're familiar with HubSpot, is one of the digital marketing tools, automation na ginagamit ng mga marketer yan. Email, so CRM, so it's combination, which is a powerful tool. Ang sabi niya, conversion rate optimization or CRO is the process of increasing the percentage of user or website visitors who complete a specific action to increase the number of leads you generate. So with that definition from HubSpot, so almost same lang naman if you will search online, what is the definition of CRO? It's the science of conversion from your website visitors. So depending on your KPI or key performance indicators, kung ano yung gusto nyo i-track, the number of leads, the number of sales, the number of engagement. So dun magbe-base ang CRO natin, how we will improve that. So according naman kay Neil Patil, sa mga SEO dito, familiar kayo for sure kay Neil Patil, no? She is one of the good SEO guy in the market right now. So marami siyang sa kanya yung Uber suggest if you have tried that software. So more on keywords, answer the public kay Neil Patil yon. So his definition of CRO is CRO is a digital marketing strategy aimed at increasing the amount of visitors who take a specific action on your website. It could be something as a simple clicking on a video or signing up to a mailing list. Alternatively, it could be a sale or subscription order. So, yun naman definition ni Neil Patil. But this one, ito yung pinakagusto kong definition ng CRO from Hotjar. Hotjar is ito yung one of the tools na most common na ginagamit ng mga CRO specialists. So, according to them, conversion rate optimization is the practice of increasing the percentage of users who perform a desired action on a website. So desired action, also called conversions, can include purchasing a product, clicking, add to cart, or filling out a form. Successful CRO strategies aim to increase conversion by focusing on the customer experience. So ito yung pinakamahalagang aspect sa CRO. So conversion is always about customer experience. So kaya nga dun sa topic natin, it involves the psychology behind conversion. So many different factors from the data, hypothesis, analysis that we will tackle later on is to help your customer experience, to help them to understand what your product is and how can it relate to them. So this is one of the good definition ng CRO. So who is a CRO specialist? So who can be a CRO specialist, guys? Ito. A CRO conversion specialist utilizes various data analysis techniques to gain valuable insights into user behavior and website performance. So if we can see here, so these are the foundation for conversion rate optimization or a CRO specialist. If you would like to take this career path, I'm telling you right now, the most useful tools or most useful skills that you need is data analysis. It's all about data. CRO is a data-driven marketing approach. So, importante dito, question that we need to ask before we start this data analysis is, of course, the reliability of the data. Kasi we will base all of the approach from the data that we will get. So, reputable ba yung data na pinanggalingan, nang i-analyze natin, nang i-optimize natin? How reputable the data that we can get? Is it measurable? So, yun ang mga important facts before we start with the data analysis, no? So, okay. They drives digital change by exploring where data analysis, user behavior, and digital marketing leads. Their duties include improving website conversion rates, turning visitors into customers with deep expertise. They run analytic audits, track user behavior, and make A/B testing for different website elements to optimize the user experience. So, ito yung definition ng CRO specialist. So, again, ito yung magiging role nyo if you want to take this career path. This is the summary. The main core of your duty is to improve the website conversion and turning visitors into customers. Okay. There are two major ways how the CRO specialists conduct their analysis. The first one is what they call quantitative analysis. What is quantitative analysis? CRO specialists employ quantitative data analysis, examining numerical data and metrics. Medyo technical to, itong quantitative analysis. Medyo may konting math, magamit tayo. So, wala tayong magagawa, even though we choose this career path, we cannot avoid math. So, math is everywhere, even with this career. So, they use web analytic tools like Google Analytics to track and measure user interaction, traffic pattern, conversion rate, bounce rate, session duration, and other relevant metrics. So, this data helps them understand how users navigate through the website and where they may encounter roadblocks. So, ito yung pinaka-ano niya. Meron ba sa inyo rito familiar with Google Analytics or probably yung mga SEO guy here? Please raise your hand. Okay, thumbs up. Okay. Okay. So, yan. So, quantitative analysis focuses more on the data from Google Analytics. So, nakikita natin dyan yung mismo specific. So, sabi nga nila, data don't lie. So, ito yung something that we can rely. This is a reliable data that we can get. So, it is very important na yung website is naka-installed yung Google Analytics for tracking natin. So, with SEO people, they're familiar with this. So, mostly with the SEO guy or SEO specialists here, they use these tools to check what particular page has the highest visitors, the blog site, so they can check na, okay, this blog page has getting more visitors. Then they will study some relevant keywords and then they will adjust accordingly. But with the help of CRO, so overall data yan. So yung bounce rate, yung session duration, traffic patterns. So, we will discuss this later on, guys, by the way. So, don't worry. So, the other portion of the analysis, data analysis is the qualitative analysis. In addition to quantitative data, CRO specialists also conduct qualitative analysis to gather deeper insights into user behavior. This may involve user feedback through survey, user testing sessions, heat maps and sessions recording. Qualitative data provides valuable context and helps them understand why behind users' actions and preferences. This is more on field study na to. Ito yung we will use some tools which I mentioned earlier, yung Hotjar. They are very famous with the tools like the heat maps. So, didiscuss natin ano ba yung heat maps. So, basically, the heat maps will help us to understand the user's behavior. Paano ba yung nagiging galaw ng mga websites visitor natin sa website natin? What are they clicking? So, napaka-importante yan. So, user testing sessions, yun. Ito yung mga nag-A/B split test yan. So, kumihingi tayo ng mga feedbacks, mga forums, mga forms. So, yun. Yeah, use feedback, session recordings. So there are tools that we can use to record the actual activities of our user visitors or website visitors. Natatrack nyo yun. For example, anong ginamit niya? Is it mobile? Is it a desktop? Is it an iPad? So they can track that. Ilang, how many hours, how many minutes sila nag-stay for that particular page? Ano yung mga kinilik nila? They can record it, which can help us to analyze the data. So, ito yun sa mga qualitative analysis yan. So, what are conversion optimization specialist requirements? Ito. The conversion optimization specialist requirements typically include technical skills, analytical abilities, and marketing knowledge. A solid understanding of digital analytics and user behavior is prerequisite for becoming a CRO specialist. The most frequent appearing skills requirements for CRO position are the following. Okay, may nag-raise hands. Okay. Is there any question here? May nag-raise na hands. Is CRO applicable to social media analytics or website analytics? Okay. Well, that's a good question because if we will search the meaning of CRO like I provided earlier, they focus more on website lang. Diba? So, na most commonly ang ginagamit nila ng CRO or website. But, and with your question, is it applicable to social media? Yes. Into a holistic approach. Because sometimes we use ad campaigns, diba? So, we will try to optimize that particular ad campaign to create a better conversion rate. Like we can track the PPC, the ROAS, click-through rate. So, importante din na nagagamit natin siya sa social media. So, it is applicable in the digital world, not only website, but mas nagiging na-emphasize lang si CRO sa website because when we have a website, we can install or we can put some tracking tools that can help us analyze more. Unlike in social media, though they have their own analytics, that the insights, data that they provide to us, it cannot go deeper with the tools that provided by the CRO specialists. So, yun. So, okay, that's a good question. So, okay, bakal tayo dito. So, ano yung mga skills or ability requirements to become a good CRO specialist? Unang-una, understanding of digital marketing fundamentals. So, it is essential if you want to choose this career path na you have a basic understanding at least of digital marketing fundamentals like branding, brand awareness, brand recognition, customer avatar, customer lifetime value. At least you understand those. And then, the next one is data analysis and interpretation skills. So, this is more on technical skills na kailangan niya natin. Like, I would suggest if you want to take this career path, mag-aral tayo na mag-aral more on Google Analytics. Merong mga pre-courses lang yan online that can give you more idea, that can give you more knowledge in terms of data analysis. So, yeah, napakahalaga yan. Then, A-B testing and experimentation. So, yon, you're familiar with A-B speed testing. So, most probably, yung mga gumagawa nito is mga designer, web developer, they're familiar with this. So, some UX, UI, oh, they're already familiar with this one. So, they are a good candidate to become a CRO specialist. Okay, sorry. Okay. Guys. So, user experience, UX and user interface knowledge. So, yun, as I mentioned, mas may advantage dito yung familiar na with UX UI. Because CRO is closely related to UX UI, but they are not. So, parang si UX UI, meron silang almost same principles, same background na nagagamit. But, okay. Oh. So, UX, UI experience sila nagagamit, pero hindi sila iisa. They are totally different. Later on, i-discuss natin yan. So, user keyword search intent analysis. Yan. So, yung mga SEO specialists here, a good skills din for you guys to become a CRO specialist. So, just a question, guys, sa mga SEO dito. Just a question, guys. So, what do you think is the most important skills to become an SEO specialist? For SEO, anong pinaka-importante? Survey tayo dito sa mga SEO expert dito. There's no wrong answer here. So, gusto ko lang malaman yung inputs nyo. Being an SEO, what do you think is the most important skills to become an SEO? Okay, tingnan natin sa Q&A. Keyword research, okay. Analytics, okay, that is good. Relevant keywords, okay, tama yan. Copywriting, which is good also. So, those that you mentioned are important elements for a good SEO skills. But for me, I believe the most important in SEO is to understand the user search intent. Kasi sometimes, di ba, parang the user search intent will bring us the conversion that we need. Kasi sometimes, experience-wise, ang daming keywords na ginagamit na sa particularly na nakikita natin sa website when we track Google Analytics, when we use certain tools like SEMrush, Moz, or SEO Suite, Ahrefs, SE Ranking, makikita natin doon na sometimes ang dami traffic coming for that particular keywords, but there is no conversion. So, for me, the important factors to become an SEO specialist is to study the search user search intent. Kasi user search intent, sometimes, ito yung pain points nila. Why they are searching in Google. Like, for example, skin whitening for a particular keyword, di ba? They're looking for a particular solution to their problem, which is they want to have a whiter skin. So, ano yung search intent nila doon? How to have a more whiter skin? So, doon natin makikita yung connected keywords that we can add. So, yung user search intent, I believe, will help us to give more relevant result in terms of SEO. So, okay. Teka lang, guys. Ano ako ata aking video. Okay. So, moving to the next. So, creative design principle. So, yung mga may background na dito sa mga design is applicable din. Because we all know everything starts with visual. In marketing, what attracts is a good design. Tama? So, especially right now, napaka fast-paced ng ano natin, technology, like social media. Sometimes sa mobile phone natin, pag may dumaang ads dyan, scroll up ka lang ng scroll up. So, design principles is very helpful skills that you should have if you want to become a CRO specialist. And of course, copywriting. Napakahalaga ng copywriting skills. So, important yan kasi dyan malalaman kung gaano ka-relevant with regards of the content and then the authority for that particular website that we want to have a better conversion. So, of course, a good copywriting is always essential for this role. Okay. Moving to the next. So, do you have any particular question before we move to another topic? Okay, so okay. Okay. So no more questions. Okay, we will proceed with the next topic. Okay. May nag-raise na hands. Please type in your question below sa Q&A natin. And I'm checking right now yung mga question. Okay. We will proceed na with the next topic. So, the CRO process. So, there are five major step or processes involved in a CRO. Actually, there are more, but I summarize it into five categories. So, step one, data research and analysis. Step two, create hypotheses. Step three, optimize designs. Step four, implementation and testing. Step five, learning and improvement. So, okay. So, let's check them one by one. So, first, data research and analysis. Okay, without accurate and comprehensive data, it's impossible to understand the behavior of website visitors and make informed decisions about how to improve the website. So, sabi ko nga, CRO, ang pinaka-core niya is more on data. So, data research analysis, ito yung number one na dapat meron tayo. We know how to read, we know how to understand the data implemented to us. Lalo na now, na sa panahon ngayon, yung mga mas better na when it comes to machine learning. So, it helps to gather and generate more relevant data. So, mas accurate na yung data ang binibigay nila ngayon sa mga, in terms of digital world. So, nakakatulong itong mga data to para mas ma-analyze natin ano ba yung tamang approach na gagawin natin, what will be the next steps. Diba? Parang, what is your user behavior? Ano ba yung pinakamaraming categories, category-based ng visitors ng website mo? Is it more on entertainment? Is it more on gaming? So, anong platform ang ginagamit nila? Is it more on mobile? Is it more on desktop? Or is it more on laptop? Or ano yung demographics niya? Ano yung age bracket ng visitors ng website mo? Is it from 18 to 25, more on adult or senior? So, very important yan. Makikita natin yung data natin dyan. So, the next step for the CRO process is create hypothesis. So, create hypothesis. Hypothesis is a statement that express a possible explanation for a problem or an opportunity on your website based on data and research. It also predicts the expected outcome of a test and how it will affect your conversion rate. So makita natin dito with this graph. Meron natin dito with this illustration, sorry. Yung process involves within a hypothesis. So state your research hypothesis. So, most of you probably familiar na dito eh. In elementary days or high school, even in college, we try to do this like with hypothesis, yung mga science experimentation natin, gumagamit tayo nitong hypothesis na to. So, state your research hypothesis, collect data in a way designed to test the hypothesis, perform an appropriate statistical test, decide whether to reject or fail your hypothesis, present the findings in your results, and it's a cycle, it's a repetitive cycle for your hypothesis. So, important itong hypothesis because dito natin nakikita yung posibleng maging outcome ng mga test natin, ng mga data na ginagawa natin. When we are formulating a good hypothesis, sabi dito, hypothesis helps you focus your testing efforts on the most important and impactful changes and avoid wasting time and resources on a random or irrelevant experiment. So, makakatipid siya ng time natin with this hypothesis based from the data. So, hindi naman tayo mahihirapan na to create our own hypothesis because meron na tayong nag-gather na data and we will implement that data para makita natin, okay, this is the next step that we can implement into our website. Ito yung pwede natin baguhin. Ito pwede natin i-change. This may affect the visitor's behavior when we change this particular section. For example, the hero banner of a website. Hero banner, like the upper poles, the sliding area. Minsan, nakakaroon ng substantial impact yan sa conversion rate natin. So with this hypothesis, it will help us to get an insights na, okay, if we try these several changes, this outcome is possible. Okay. And then the next part is optimized design. Ayan. 94% of first impressions are related to design. So it's essential to lay content out in a way that looks nice and makes sense. So we have a principle called AIDA principle. It's attention, interest, desire, action. So have you encountered this terminology, guys? Just raise your hands. This AIDA principle. Okay. Yes, very good. So, mostly nagagamit to sa design. Eh. So, it is applicable in every design aspect. UX, UI, ginagamit din to mga graphic designers, web designers. So, even just creating a simple banner ads or campaign ads for Facebook, it really helps a lot. No? So, to AIDA principle na to, attention, interest, desire, action. So, ano ba yung attention? Sometimes we will use an image that will grab attention. No? Or ano ba yung pinaka main offer na meron yung ads natin? So, attention. So, interest. Something that will get your target audience interest. Something that they can be parang relevant sa interest nila. So, put something na makakapuko ng interest ng mga target viewers natin or target customers. Desire. And then, ano yung desire? Ano ba yung pwede nating captions na gamitin sa pinaka-design natin? Ilagay doon, like, ano yung pinaka-main offerings niya? Na parang unique selling proposition na meron ino-offer. So, in just a simple way, we could add that into the design. And then, action. So, pinaka-importante dyan, very clear yung action natin, yung CTA. Yung CTA, minsan, it plays an important role, no? Not just in the website, but sometimes in just a simple ad campaign, nakakatulong din yung ano na yan, mga CTA actions na yan. So, implementing this AIDA principle into your design, optimizing your design, plays an important part to a better conversion rate. So, optimized designs. Ayan. UA designs focuses on the visual and interactive elements of the website, such as the layout, color schemes, typography, icons, buttons, and other graphical elements. It aims to create a visually appealing user interface that guides the audience to the user experience crafted by the UX designers. So, yan. Mahalaga yung factor na yan, yung typography. Sometimes, with the different type of fonts, it will connect you to your target audience. Sometimes if your website is more on a professional or a corporate one, of course it should reflect on the overall look of the website, from the typography, yung colors na ginagamit ba natin, yung icons, baka minsan yung icons na ginagamit natin masyadong cute, which is not relevant sa mga target audience natin, yung buttons natin, baka masyadong saturated with gradients, updated ba siya with the latest trend designs, yung mga section ba ng website natin, minsan yung mga transitions will play an important part. So dito nagiging advantage if you are a UX UI specialist. That's why I mentioned earlier, if you are a UI UI specialist, you can be a good candidate to become a CRO specialist then, kasi you understand mostly everything, like the user journey, customer behavior, naiintindihan natin yon because we create some study. So, napakahalaga na i-optimize natin ang design. So, number four, part of the process of CRO is implementation and testing. So, a CRO testing refers to the experiments you run on your website to see what improves the chances of visitors taking desired action and becoming customers. So, planning a testing strategy is a crucial step in building a successful CRO and A/B testing framework. To create an effective, it's important to first define your goals and objective for experimentation. So, ito na yon. So, meron ka ng na-research mo na ano yung mga data. May pinagkukuha ka na. Meron ka ng basis, reliable basis na dapat mong gawin. And then, you create a hypothesis kung ano yung pwedeng maging outcome with that particular data. And then you created your designs. You created certain adjustment. And then the next goal is to implement that. So create A/B split testing. So, pero ba dito sa inyo familiar na sa A/B split test? Or mismo nag-try na mag-A/B split test? Okay. So, very helpful yung A/B split test na yan because makikita natin with just a different minor changes to a particular landing page or a particular website page, nagkakaroon ng malaking difference. Even with campaign ads, ginagawa yun ng mga social media manager sometimes. So, social media manager here, for sure, na-encounter nyo na yan, A/B split test. Sometimes, you are using the same messaging, but using different images, or you are using the same images, but you are using different headlines or different CTAs. So, upon A/B split test, dyan natin makikita which gets more attentions, which gets more impressions, which gets more engagement, and at the end, which gets more the actual conversions. And then, the next one is, so this is the last one, learning and improvement sa process natin, no, ng CRO. So, conversion rate optimization is a process of exploration and refinement, demanding patience. The most important aspect is that each test, regardless of its outcome, contributes to a deeper understanding of your audience and fosters an environment of continuous improvement. So, makikita natin dito, so, sa continuous cycle, reflect what happened, what are the results, generalize what went well, what could be improved, what we will do now. So, ang CRO, it's not a one-stop marketing approach na once you implemented, tapos na. It's a continuous and improvement from time to time. Sabi nga dito, nagbabago ang behavior ng mga website visitors natin. Maraming deciding factors na nag-trigger sa kanila to convert and sometimes mabilis magbago. So, hindi pwede na implement mo na yon, yun na yon, basic na yon. So, minsan nakikita natin maraming mga company na nagre-rebrand ng website nila. Or not just make it the whole website, just the particular brand sometimes, di ba? Marami na taon na yung brand nila pero nagre-rebranding pa din sila. Diba? Because it's part of learning and improvements. They're doing some A/B split test. So, yung Dunkin' Donut before, diba? Naging Dunkin' na lang sila ngayon because they want to represent a different brand that can compete to Starbucks. Before, parang pag sinabi natin Dunkin' Donut, ang unang papasok sa isip natin are donuts. Diba? But now, they want to be associated like a cafe which can be compete to Starbucks. So, they created it like ano yung branding nila na Dunkin na lang instead of Dunkin Donuts. So it may take some time for us to adjust with the particular, but they started it. So yun ang importance. So nagbabago. Hindi porket na-achieve mo na yung CRO na nagkaroon ka na ng good results. For example, in this particular testing, in this particular phase, we tested na nagkaroon ng issues, we figure out na nagkaroon ng problema pala yung isang landing page natin ng website kaya hindi nagkakaroon ng conversion or maraming visitors ang umaalis sa website na hindi nagte-take ng action like signing up or clicking into the next particular landing page. And then we created some adjustment. Iisipin natin na yun na yun, tapos na. Because from time to time, months from now, what will happen, makikita mo na ang baba na naman ng conversion niya, which will calls for another testing, another CRO process for us to implement another steps. So it's a continuous repeat process. So, okay, review tayo. Ano yung 5 steps for a CRO process? Unang-una, number 1 steps is this, you should have a data and research analysis. And then second, once may data na tayo, reliable data na makukuha, create a hypothesis that we can help us to understand what is the possible outcome. Ano yung pwede maging results nito based from the data that we get. And then, design optimization, the 3rd steps. So, optimize the design, whether it is a landing page, whether it is a website, whether it is a social media banners, or what everything optimize the designs. And then the next one, create an A/B split test. Create different version to test which one will get a better result, which one will get a better conversion, which one could get a better engagement. And then the last steps is learning and repeat. Okay? So any particular question before we move into a next topic? Just put your question in the Q&A. So any question, guys? Okay, we will proceed with the next topic. So key metrics and goals. Okay. This is very important because we need to know ano ba yung conversion na kailangan natin. Ano yung tinitingnan natin? What will be the standards? There are many different metrics and goals. It will depend on your business. It will depend on your employer if ever you will become a CRO specialist, no? So it will depend with them ano yung gusto nila na maging results. But eto yung mga metrics and goals na usually under CRO. So understanding and picking the right CRO metrics is essential for any business looking to succeed online. These crucial metrics help you gauge the effectiveness of your website, identify areas for improvement, and ultimately drive more conversions. So to make data-driven decisions and improve your website conversion rate, it's vital to monitor the right CRO metrics. So, importante, it is essential that we know what exact metrics that we want to track for us to consider the CRO is successful. Diba? So, it will depend on the expectation from your client, from your employer. Ano ba yung gusto nilang metrics na makukuha? But basically, ito yung mga metrics na usually tina-track natin. Here are the top 10 metrics you should track. Number one is conversion rate. Second, bounce rate. Number three, average time. Number four, new users versus returning users. Number five, the customer lifetime value or the CLV. And then, customer acquisition. Average order value, cart abandonment rate, click-through rate, and traffic source. So, we will discuss them one by one lang. Daanan lang natin sila. Again, masyadong malaking topic to. So, we're just trying to trim it down just to give you an overview. So, first is the conversion rate. So, the conversion rate is the most important of all CRO metrics as it looks at how many website visitors complete a particular desired action. So sabi ko nga, like buying something or submitting information. By monitoring this rate, you can assess how effective your site and marketing efforts are. It helps you identify areas that need improvement for a better user experience and ultimately more conversion. So basically, ito yung formula natin for a conversion rate. So number of visitors that converted, and then total number of visitors multiplied by 100. So, dito natin makikita. So, kung ilan yung number ng visitors ba, and then ilan yung sa mga yon ang nag-convert, conversion will depend, like mentioned in this one, like buying or submitting information, like filling up some forms, or subscribing to a newsletter, or watching some video views, part ng conversion yan. So, the next one is the bounce rate. Eto. This is very important then. Bounce rate is the percentage of website visitors who leave your website without any action such as clicking on a link. They don't even bother themselves to scroll down on your website. So bounce rate is an important metric that you should measure. A high bounce rate means people don't get what they want and leave your site as soon as they arrive. But a low bounce rate means people are satisfied with your content and page. So, tingnan natin tong data rito. Kita nyo ba yung data dito? So, makikita natin dito yung bounce rate niya. These are good results when it comes to bounce rate. So, bounce rate that are lower than 50% are good. But yung bounce rate na 50%, 60 to 100, yan na, ibig sabihin napakataas. Pagbagsak sa website mo for a particular page, sometimes they just exit without reading, without taking any action, without even scrolling. So ibig sabihin napakalaki ng adjustment. By knowing the number of bounce rate, dito natin malalaman kung yung particular page ba na yon needs a certain improvement. So kailangan ba niya, ano yung parts, ano yung pages na kailangan natin i-adjust to improve the bounce rate. So itong example na to, they are good. So meaning they are spending more time with your particular website into a particular page. So it means relevant sa kanila yung nakikita nila. So sabi ko nga, importante yung skills ng copywriting because dito it plays the important part for bounce rate. Dito natin nakikita. The more relevant content provided by a good copywriter, the more it will reduce the bounce rate for a better results. So, yon. So, average time. So, the average duration people spend on a web page provides an insight into how engaged, interested they are in the content. This metric is a great way to measure how efficient your website's user experience, content, and load speed genuinely are. If users remain on the page longer than usual, it may suggest that what you're providing is exciting or captivating enough to keep them around. So, almost same din to with bounce rate, no? The more they spend time, the more we can see here na yung result. Tingnan natin to. Ang medyo tricky siya dito. If you will see here, the average time they spend on a page is 3 minutes, which is good. But ang taas ng bounce rate niya. So, is there any one of you? Parang guess lang, bakit ganon? Ang tagal naman ng tinigil nila sa page, pero ang taas ng bounce rate. Bakit? Minsan ganon yung results sa Google Analytics. Makikita, kasi sa, one day when you use Google Analytics, may encounter nyo yung ganito, magugulat kayo. Sabihin mo, ang tagal naman ng in-spend time nila, average spend time nila, pero ang taas ng bounce rate. Bakit? Umalis ka agad doon sa page. So, any wild guess, guys? Okay. So, minsan kasi, yung page na tinatrack natin is mga e-commerce yan. Minsan yung mga page na natatrack is eto, particularly, isa ay subscription page. Merong mga login. So, sometimes, di ba, pag login, ang bilis lang. Pag-input lang information mo, then alis ka kagad. Sometimes, it affects the bounce rate. So, itong results na to, it doesn't mean na mataas yung bounce rate niya. Pero pag tinignan natin yung average time for you, is nag-i-spend ng 3 minutes. 3 minutes, it's a good number na. Kasi makikita mo, if you will track a Google Analytics, sometimes seconds lang ang tinatagal ng mga web visitors for a particular page. Sometimes, ang 20 seconds nga is a good results na eh. So, in totality, this is a good total na rin. So, yun, particular reason niya. Okay? So, I think magkakaroon tayo ng icebreaker at 2 p.m. before we proceed with the next one. Guys, from Beam.
Yes, let's take a break, sir.
Okay. So, yun, guys. Ano na tayo? Quick break muna tayo. Magpapagames ata sila. No?
Ayan, tama si sir. Tayo.
Yeah. Okay.
Inom so ko muna ng tubig, sir.
We will continue later. Teka lang.
Yeah. So, ayun, guys. Tayo ay magpapagames ulit. So, sa mga nandito na dati, meron tayong games in between para makapagpahinga naman si speaker. And with that, pwede kayo manala na ang tumataging ting na Miss Blessy. Magkano yung price na Miss Blessy?
Negosyo pa, Kate. Tara. Sana
ako. Mananalo kayo ng 50
pesos. Ang inyong Gcash. Okay.
So, yon ma'am. Ano yung mechanics ng game? Simple lang po. Meron po kaming ipapakita sa inyo. And then, unahan sa makakasagot. Unahan. Bali, ilagay niyo lang po yung sagot sa Q&A. Hindi po sa chat. Sa Q&A po. And then, kung sino po yung kauna-unahang tao nung makasagot nung logo, picture, or what, yun po yung aming mananalo. And pakisend po yung Gcash nyo doon sa mamaya hihina lang namin.
At the end of the game.
Yes,
okay,
ma'am.
So, time's up naman para sa mga ready ng manalo. Thumbs up, thumbs up, thumbs up. Nag-start tayo. Ayan, okay.
Dami.
Ano to? May natutunan na sila. May pa-premyo pa, no?
Yes. Ma'am.
Okay.
Saka pa,
so,
diba?
Let's start. Check ko lang kung okay na. Alright. So, yan. Ang ating palaro ay 4 picks, 1 word. So, I think alam niyo naman na to. So, 4 picks siya. Ang mga 7-letter word lang ito. Lahat sila 7-letter words. So, medyo mahaba siya. So, mga 10 ang mananalo. Mark, again, help me with the
10
name.
10 po, ma'am.
Oo. So, yan. Mag-start na tayo. Wait lang. Open ko yung Q&A para nakikita ko din yung mga sagot. Lang. Alright. Huwag naman anonymous attendee. Medyo bobo ako nito. Okay. So, let's start. 3, 2, 1. Type in your answer.
Meron na ba? Meron na? Mm-hmm.
Tama naman. Security ang sagot. Sino ba sa time ninyo? Timestamp 159. Karen sa akin.
Okay.
Karen Kirimo Nietes.
Ah, Karen Nietes. Ang tamang sagot ay security. May sumagot authority, monitor, business, surveillance. Surveillance. Okay. Policeman.
Karen.
Oh, okay.
Congrats, Karen.
Congrats.
Yes. Okay, so move na tayo sa next na palaro or 4 picks, 1 word. So nagtapos tayo kay Bemil. Okay. Mamaya na po yung attendance list. Stay po kayo at the end of the webinar. Okay? Next is this one.
Ano yan, ma'am? Ah!
Parang alam ko na to, sir, ma'am.
Doctor, discuss.
Malayo.
Leader, discussion, business.
Uy, may muntik.
Uy! May muntik na. Uy, ma'am, meron ako nakita,
ma'am. Meron na din sa akin.
See, eyes.
Yes,
eyes, matutulan.
Eyes, digital.
Mukhang meron siyang... Hi, ma'am, eyes.
Eyes, hello? Eyes, baby, matutulan. Okay, ang tamang sagot ay dictate.
Dictate.
May,
sayang yung kanina, dictator eh.
Oo, anonymous.
Anonymous attendee, dictator daw, pero hindi po coach, speaker, dictate. Okay, so eyes, ating pangalawa. Alright, yay, sabi niya. Okay, next.
Uy. Yan, ma'am.
Keyboard warriors, sagot.
Uy! Grabe
ay,
naman
grabe
si ano.
Grabe naman.
Uy, anonymous attendee, type mo yung pangalan mo para ma-acknowledge ka namin.
Grabe yung anonymous.
Galit na galit, ma'am.
Anonymous attendee ka lang kasi hindi ka namin ma-ano.
Pakitype.
Anonymous attendee.
Oo.
Yan.
Pinat ko na siya, ma'am.
Pinat ka na niya.
Ang galing.
Antay natin ang sagot kasi anonymous attendee lang siya.
Anonymous. Cool. Hindi ka mananalo ng 50 pesos.
Artist, firefly,
pang
colorful.
Yan. Wag ka.
Royalty. Okay. Hindi po
so, ang tamang sagot po ay?
Monarch.
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 Yes po, dito po sa Q&A, sa sagot.
Opo. Nakikita po namin lahat ng...
Amabel, inserto dito. Oh, tama yung...
Ma'am, parang ano... Ah, hindi. Chinat ko naman po si anonymous attendees, no?
Ah, magre-reply
yan. Magre-reply siya.
So, pag
kasi
di siya
magre-reply
sa'yo, hindi niya makiklaim. Hindi ka namin napanganalan kasi na nakalagay dito anonymous, ano ka lang, attendee. Pero
opo.
Tama.
Pero tama ka.
Ibigyan ka namin ng chance hanggang mamaya. Pag wala, no chance. Okay? Hindi wala na
anonymous.
Namin pero may nanalo si anonymous. Nag-aantay lang kami ng reply. Alright?
Anonymous, hanggang mamaya ka na lang, anonymous.
Replyan mo si Mark, nag-chat sa sayo. Okay, so move tayo sa fourth. Yan, fourth picture.
Yan. Ay!
Ay, grabe yan.
Marites to, Marites. Oy, hindi po.
Hindi.
Silent whisper, zipper. Gossip, silence.
Isabol lips daw
Piton.
ako.
Zip, secret, overlook.
Ay, medyo
Whisper ko
nahirapan
lang
yung mga
eh.
Wonder VA.
Pero hindi po yun. Wait lang.
Ay, muntik na dito.
Ay, muntik na.
Oy! Si
Ay,
Ming,
padlock ba,
muntik
ma'am?
ka na. Ma'am, padlock daw.
Ah, padlock.
Ay, meron na, meron na, meron na.
Ay, meron na,
Uy,
ma'am.
three, ma'am.
Double M.
Sino, ma'am? Timestamp, ano?
203.
Sino po sa inyo, ma'am?
Trisha sa
Sa akin, Trisha, ma'am.
Ah, Trisha, anong oras?
203 din.
03.
Trisha lang siya.
Trisha?
After nung muntik na.
Si Privacy kasi hindi po siya eh. Sino sa'yo, ma'am?
Ah, sige, sige. Siguro nga.
Anong pangalan sa'yo? Parang wala. Yun, si Trisha ang ating winner. Okay?
Yes.
Ang sagot po ay private.
Trisha.
Trisha na walang apelido. Andito.
Trisha na walang apelido.
Masyang apelido. Okay. So next is this one. Rocks, cookies. Dessert, fruits, peel, bricks, dessert. Hindi
Ano
po.
to, ma'am eh?
Oh, meron na.
Ay,
Catherine.
meron na.
Catherine
Catherine.
Landicho. Ang sagot ay crumble.
Crumble.
Red, broken pattern pieces. Pudding. Brown breakfast. Okay.
Breakfast.
Okay,
Ay,
mamaya.
gutom. Pang-anim na natin, ma'am.
Oo, pang-anim na. Ay, nakaka-type ka po sa chat. Anonymous attendee. Kita po namin. Don't worry. Alright. So, eto na. Next. Ano nga yan? Ayun mo.
Meron na. May
Sino
Atilano?
po? May Atilano po.
Oo,
oo,
ma'am.
May Atilano. Alright. Ang tamang sagot ay combine.
Combine.
Magot formula, missing mixture, board, graphic, complete, puzzle. Okay. Ano po? Okay na po tayo dun sa combine. Combine po ang tamang sagot. Okay? So, move tayo dito.
Marites na naman yan, ma'am.
Marites. Password, shock, operate, press.
Ano ba yung sinasabi ng mga Marites? Yan.
Oo nga.
Yun
Nasabi nila.
yun.
Oy, giveaway tayo sa other, ano, kasi si Catherine nakuha niya eh. Giveaway to others. Elevate, hindi po. Gossip, password, upskill, secret, password.
Colin.
Ano bang past tense?
Ma'am Colin Teves, 206.
Ah, Colin Teves.
Po.
Ah, nga. Colin.
Yeah. Ang tamang sagot
Colin
ay
Teves.
stories. Yan, mga Marites.
Sorry.
May nagsa stories. Gumawa ng
I'm
stories.
very, very sorry.
Okay, naman. Yung whisper, privacy elevator. Hindi ako ba naano yung elevate? Kasi, okay. So, move tayo. Pang-8 na to, no?
Yes, ma'am.
Ayan. Uy, mainit na panahon.
Ay, ano yan?
Hindi po. Malapit na sa weather.
Kuya
Temperature.
Kim? Kuya
Raising
Kim po ba yan,
temperature.
ma'am? Oy, Casey,
Meron
wala
na.
akong apelido, ha?
Meron na. Jocelyn?
Jocelyn po sa inyo, ma'am.
Jocelyn Salvador.
Ah, tama.
Jocelyn Salvador.
Jocelyn P. Salvador.
Ang tamang sagot ay climate. Season.
Jocelyn P. Salvador. Buong buo.
Malalim si Jot.
Last two.
Celsius.
Philippines daw, ma'am. Philippines. Tama si sir. Philippines,
tama,
ma'am.
Tama siya.
Casper, ano Caspride ba yan? Caspride. Ang ganda ng pangalan. Okay, number 9. Sagot. Sealed.
Labit
Animal.
na yun.
Cages. Hindi ka na si sealed.
Judiel, oh, nakikita answer mo, Judiel.
Kita answer mo, Judiel. Type mo na, sayang. Kofine, ano kofine? Freedom, letters, prison, secured in cage. Malapit na sa in cage. Captured, fence, secured, sealed, confined, mailbox, sender.
Yun, meron na, meron na, meron na.
Galing.
Ang sagot, oo. Nahanap mo baka ma-letter D eh. Si Trisha ba yan?
Oo, walang letter D. Pero okay na siguro to.
Ah, wala naman letter D talaga. Seven letter... Okay. Tama na yan.
Trisha Sagid.
Iba to sa...
Dalawang Trisha yung... Walang opo, ma'am. Si Trisha, walang apelido yung isa eh.
Yung siya niya kayo na NHIA. Okay. O, oh, enclosed.
Anonymous attendee. Wala ka pa rin pangalan.
Oo, oh, nako. Baka magpalaro pa ako sa mamaya, ibigay ko. Okay,
oh,
next
nga.
One. Go, go, go. Ano sagot, sabi ni Dredge? Enclosed po ang sagot.
Enclosed po ang sagot.
Teach, learning, mocking. Lecture, inform.
Meron na, meron na, meron na, meron na.
Si Baba.
Baby. Ay, kala ko baby, ma'am. Naku po, Diyos ko. Iba yung nababasa ko, ma'am.
Oh my Bye, God, sino baby yan, Mark?
Si Baba, Kylo, or Jail ba yan?
Baba.
Baba, Jail o bala.
Command. Okay.
Ayan.
Okay, pa-recap naman po ng sagot.
Ma'am, eto na. Nagbigay na ng pangalan si, ano, si Anonymous
Ina,
Attendee.
Si Ina Mariel ba yon? Tama ba?
Opo.
Okay. Oh, Ina Mariel, shout out sa iyo. Ikaw si Anonymous.
Okay. So, ang mga nanalo, ma'am.
Go.
Karen Kirimo Nietes. Eyes Matutulan. Ina Mariel Pantaleon. Trisha ang walang apelido, ma'am.
Okay.
Ano magagawin natin
doon? Okay, Trisha na ngayong apelido. Ang mabuo.
Catherine Landicho. May Atilano. Colleen Teves. Jocelyn P. Salvador, Trisha Sagid, and baby, ah, Baba J-Lo.
Okay, so congratulations everyone. Type in nyo na ang inyong GCash number dito sa Q&A tab para ma-send na sa inyo ang worth 50 pesos sa inyong GCash. Make sure, verify na ngayon GCash para matanggap ninyo ang inyong mga papremyo, okay?
Ma'am, ano daw po yung answer sa number 10? Yung po ay command.
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 Okay, so let's go back to our proper programming.
Sir Jeff, are you ready? Nakainom ka na ba ng napakalamig na tubig, Sir Jeff?
Okay, so yun. Thank you, guys. So, congrats sa mga nanalo sa games natin. Okay. So, we can
okay,
proceed
sir.
Na with the next batch ng ano natin, no? Sharing my screen. So, okay, review guys ulit. So, average time, next one natin is new users versus returning users. So, new users versus returning users show you the average of first-time visits to your site. This metric tells you how many visits on your website are first-time users and how many are returning users. This both measures your marketing effort as well as your ads targeting new traffic. So, by the way, guys, ito nakikita natin dito, hindi siya parang default in Google Analytics 4, no? So, you need some special skills in Google Analytics 4 para ma-setup natin siya. Kasi ngayon, in the adjustment with the Google Analytics 4, usually ang nakikita lang natin ay new users. So, natatrack lang natin ilan yung new users. But if we want to track ilan yung returning visitors natin, we need to set this up inside the Google Analytics. So, what is the importance of tracking the returning users? Actually, in marketing, if anyone of you nasa marketing dito, mas gusto natin yung returning visitors instead of gaining new leads. Kasi returning visitors, malaki ang chance niya na magkaroon ng conversion. Meaning, they are interested with your, someone return to your website. So, napakamahalaga na natatrack natin yan. So, next one is the customer lifetime value. So, familiar ba kayo dito, mga social media manager here? Raise your hands if you're familiar with the CLV or anyone here in the marketing department or, you know, some have some experience with this one. So, monitoring the customer lifetime value Metric helps business devise strategies to get maximum value out of customer relationship, target specific customers, and allocate resources judiciously for acquisition or retention purposes. This can be done by predicting future net profit over an entire duration with each client. So ito yung customer lifetime value natin. Yung average order value, mamaya didiscuss din natin yan. Tapos purchase frequency, gano'ng kadalasan nag-order, ilang beses na, times average customer lifetime. So kung gano'ng katagal. So for example, you are selling a subscription online. So mas madali siyang i-track na yung customer lifetime value. Ang monthly, for example, ang Netflix. Ang monthly subscription ng Netflix per users, let's just say magkano na ba, 600 pesos a month or 550 something. If you will subscribe for 1 year, let's just say, so let's just say for 500, so 5,000, it's called 6,000, tama? A year. So, ilang years ka na magsusubscribe sa Netflix? Let's just say 5 years. So, multiply that. So, 6 times 5. So, 35. So, yun ang magiging lifetime value mo. So, dun binibase ng mga marketer kung magkano ang dapat ini-spend nila per leads. So, kung ang for example, ang lifetime value ng isang leads natin is nasa 10,000 a year. So, dapat ang expenses natin to acquire that particular leads when it comes to PPC, like Facebook ads or Google ads or any other marketing efforts, we will compute that. Yung kinocompute ng mga marketing specialists yan, magkano nag-generate yan, is it enough to spend with that particular leads? Kaya nga, important na natatrack natin yung mga returning customer kasi yung mga ganitong customer lifetime value, mas magastos yung kuha ng leads kesa dito sa mga returning customer natin. Minsan, di ba, pag yung mga na-experience yung ba, nag-unsubscribe kayo sa Netflix, minsan, they have a follow-up email with you. Minsan, magkakaroon sila ng mga parang re-offering ulit na, would you like to try for another month for free? Kasi ibig sabihin nun, they value you more kasi nakikita nila kung magkano yung magiging value nila or magiging value mo sa business nila in the lifetime duration while doing business with them. So, yung napaka-importante yung metrics na minimeasure dapat to when it comes to CRO. So, next one is, do you have any question regarding this, guys? So, may question tayo dyan. So, wala. Okay. Customer acquisition cost. So, the customer acquisition cost is a key performance indicator that quantifies the average amount a company spends to gain one new customer. So, ito yon. Tracking this figure allows business to gauge how efficiently they invest in marketing activities and adjust their tactics accordingly. So, ito yung formula. Yung total expenses to attract, engage, and convert a new customer. Tapos, number of new customers acquired. So, okay. May na question. Nawala ko yung question natin. Okay. Mamaya babalikan ko yung mga question. Nawala ko yung question. Sorry, guys. So, ito yung formula dyan. Total expenses to attract, engage, and convert new customers. So, para ma-compute yung customer lifetime value, ito muna yung dapat natin inaalam. Every marketing department, every marketing specialist, business owners, dapat alam nila how much it costs to gain a new customer. Baka mas malaki yung nagastos nila to gain or to acquire a new customer or a new lead compared sa magiging lifetime value niya. So, lugi na yung business. Hindi na siya profitable. So, sa conversion rate optimization specialist, it is under your responsibility na alam din dapat natin tumaga nito. No? So, next one, the average order value. So the average order value calculates the average amount spent by customers in a single transaction. Increasing AOV is a strategic way to boost revenue without necessarily attracting more customers amount. So paano natin kino-compute to? So average order value equals total revenue equals total orders. So ito yung example niyan. For example, if you earn 2,000 in total revenue and had the 400 orders, your average order value will be 2,000 divided by 400 equals to $5. This means that on average, each customer spends $5 per purchase. So, ayan. So, I hope parang nabivisualize nyo siya kung paano yung nagiging takbo ng process natin in terms of conversion. So, first, kinumpute natin yung lifetime value. Magkano pwedeng kitain sa isang leads, sa isang customers of our particular business. And then the next thing, magkano ang budget na na-allocate or naubos ng isang marketing campaign or marketing specialist just to attract or get a new leads. At magkano yung total value na na-spend lang nila. So dito makikita natin kung nag-break even ba. So dito nakikita natin kung successful ba yung marketing campaigns. So in this type of CRO, we are measuring the success of a marketing campaign. No? Dito natin nakikita yun. So cart abandonment rate. Ito, napaka-importante nito. The cart abandonment rate is the percentage of users who had items to their shopping cart but leave before completing the purchase. A high cart abandonment rate is a concern as it represents lost potential revenue. It, sabi rin dito, it says that the average cart abandonment rate across industries is 70%. This value is an average calculated based on 49 different studies done by Bayer Institute on shopping cart abandonment. So this is for an e-commerce, no? Nakikita natin dito. Maraming factors but hindi nagtutuloy. Minsan sa checkout. So as a CRO, we have the formula on how we can track the activities, the user behavior, we have the data. Now, we can apply this with this cart abandonment rate. We can track why these are particular customers who are on the checkout page did not proceed to the actual purchasing. Bakit hindi nagtuloy? Sometimes, ang problema dito is ang hirap ng information na hinihingi. Ang dami. That's why yung mga Amazon, yung mga other e-commerce, if you will notice from their previous interface, they created a lot of adjustment just to make the checkout process seamless and easier for everyone. Minsan nga ngayon, dati, before you can purchase, you need to create an account, ihingin pa yung mga address mo, certain information. Sometimes yung mga users, tinatamad mag-type, tinatamad sa dami ng information hinihingi. They back up, not proceeding with the checkout. So, most of the e-commerce approach is just use your email, use your name, then you can proceed to the checkout, and then naput mo na information na yon. Later on, they will ask you for the shipping address, which is make it more seamless for the end users. No? So, tong cart abandon rate na to, knowing this, as a CRO, you can implement different strategies. No? So, as a CRO, para marketing na rin yan. So, sometimes, you will implement some retargeting. So, marami si atin dito nakaka-experience. Kapag meron kang check out na product, hindi natuloy. Minsan sa, for example, let's mention a e-commerce brand here in the Philippines, Shopee or Lazada. If you try sometimes na mag-order tayo, minsan yung in-order natin na yon lumalabas sa feedback sa Facebook. Please raise your hands if you encounter this. Or, just press like button if you experience this, no? Yung parang sinusundan ka ng product, pag nakita mo, hindi mo naman siya in order, pero hindi ka na tinatantanan, hanggang sa ang tendency mo, parang patulit-ulit kang nire-remind na, oh, parang ito yung product na tinignan ko last week, ah, lumalabas na lumalabas. And then, magugulat ka na lang, after a few weeks, yung tinitingnan mong product, magkakaroon ng 30% off. So, yun na yung trigger factor na, oh, 30% off, that's the time na mag-check out ka. So, sa CRO, is mainly involved for that particular strategy. So, nalalaman nila na, oh, ang daming ano ah, ang daming abandonment rate ng ano natin ah, e-commerce natin. Mag-i-implement sila ngayon, mag-run sila ng retargeting ad campaign. They will follow you through social media, through email, and then they will implement a lead nurturing series until you're ready to convert. Magkakaroon na sila ng parang okay, 30% off, 50% off, or minsan sa subscription, free trial for 15 days. Wala ka na kawala. Yun na yun. And magko-convert ka na. So, knowing this data is very important as a CRO, no? So, next one, click-through rate. CTR measures how often people click on a link or call to action in your content or ads. A high CTR generally indicates compelling content or ads that effectively encourage users to learn more or make a purchase constantly, or a higher CTR is key to driving more traffic and achieving higher conversion rate. So yung mga CTR natin, so ito lang yung simple line formula niya, number of people who click on the ad, number of people who saw the ad. Sometimes sa Google Analytics, makikita din natin yan yung click action, ilang number of clicks in a particular web page. Ibig sabihin, the more, the highest the click, the more people are interested into your content. Same with these ads. The more they click on this on your ad, means you get their interest. So your impression tumataas, yung engagement tumataas, no? So it helps for a better conversion rate. So next one, traffic source. So traffic source identify where your website visitors are coming from, whether that's organic search, paid ads, social media, or referral from other sites. Knowing your traffic sources can help you tailor your content or marketing strategies to the channel that are driving the most and highest quality traffic. So knowing where are your traffic coming from, doon natin malalaman kung saan tayo mag-i-spend ng budget. Diba? So dito, with this example, actually makita natin siya sa Google Analytics. We can track very specific kung saan nanggaling yung. You can find source, medium there. So I encourage you guys to have some lesson in Google Analytics form. Kasi if you want to become a CRO specialist, Google Analytics form number one yan. So lahat ng data nandun, maraming pre-courses din yan. Actually, si Google nag-offer ng pre-course din yan, Google Analytics. You can visit their website, take that course there. No? So dito makikita natin, galing sa organic, display, paid search, unassigned. Isa makikita natin, galing sa social media, kung ano yung social media, galing yung traffic na yon. In that way, we know where we will put more or allocate a specific budget kung saang channel siya, saang medium, saang source. No? So, very important na natatrack natin ang traffic source na ating mga leads or customers. So, okay. So, do you have any question regarding the key metrics and goals that we want to track for CRO? Any question, guys? Okay, usin na tayo dito. User experience and CRO. So, sabi ko nga, UX and CRO are distinct areas of specialization that work together to improve website performance and user experience. Minsan na pagkakamalan silang parehas eh. Kasi based on the background, based on the principles, the process that they are implementing to a particular website, kaya minsan parang they think na pag UX QA ka na, you are also a CRO, but they are really different, no? So UX will be under CRO. CRO is the larger scope, so magiging mas mataas na hierarchy siya, so under niya si UX UI. If ever it's not meaning na under, what I'm trying to say here is different sila ng pathway, but somehow they are related. So if you are a UX UI, you can become a better CRO specialist because you understand better principles like user behavior, customer journey. So UX design sets the foundation for CRO. Okay, it's the process of creating a visually appealing and user-friendly experience that evokes positive emotions and effectively communicate information. So, UX UI, more on seamless approach siya. from the word user experience once you land or particular website or landing page. Ano ba yung magiging dating nito dun sa end user? Paano niya ba gagamitin yung platform mo? Gaano kay smooth? In conversion rate principles, it helps because it helps you to analyze then kung what factors. Because remember, in our process, we have the optimizing design as part of our process. So these plays an important factor in our CRO optimization. So CRO often focuses on specific elements that influences conversion, such as button placement and styling, call to action messaging, and other design choices. It examines the route user to take move toward a specific destination. So ito. So measure analytics tracking, reports, analysis, strategy planning, design graphics, implementation. So napakalaki ng scope niya, ng sakop niya. Compared kay user experience. User experience is all about the overall experience a user has while interacting with your product or service. The strategy focuses on designing your website and landing page to make it visually appealing, smooth to navigate, and intuitive. So content strategy, information, architecture, functionality, platform, kung mobile ba yan, desktop or tablets, user interface, usability, and accessibility. Gaano kadali gamitin, gaano kasimple. So yun ang focus ni user experience that helps and supports the CRO process. No? So again, they are both different areas in terms of principle, in terms of the overall approach, but somehow they correlate and they share something in common. So ito yung user experience and design process, makikita natin dito. So research, meet the user, user demographics, define user goal, empathize, be the user, user persona, user scenarios, create. So makikita natin almost the same yung principles natin, medyo may pagkakahawi. Dito sa research, sa atin, data research and analysis. Sa CRO naman, it's more on hypothesis. Dito, empathize. Dito, create. Sa atin naman is optimize designs, test. They help both test and implementation. Develop. Sa atin naman is continuous improvement sa CRO. No? So, how UX and CRO are similar? So, we can see here. Both of them rely on user research and user interviews because we need facts, we need data, and then data informed decision making, iterative meaning repetitive, or user focus. So dito sila nagkakapareho ni UX and CRO. And then okay, let's go A/B testing and landing page optimization. So daanan natin siya ng mabilis. Because this topic is very broad din, no? Maraming factors. Hindi siya pwedeng daanan lang ng isala kung if we want to focus here. We need to set a specific lesson for this particular topic. So, A/B testing is a method that helps make driven decision, data-driven decisions by comparing different versions of a web page or app to determine which performs better. It often involves testing multiple page variants, A and B, X testing to optimize user experience and conversion rates. So like I mentioned a while ago, sometimes sa A-B split test, binabago sometimes yung heading, images, minsan simple button lang will play an important part. Minsan yung image na ginamit, nagpalitan ng image, hindi naman totally binago yung landing page or yung website, but nagkaroon ng better conversion rate. So most of you will ask me, what is the ideal conversion rate? It will depend. Anything that will give positive impact is a success to your CRO approach. 5%, 10%, 20%, 50%, the better, you know? So it doesn't matter as long as we will see the increase in conversion. So landing page optimization. So, usually sa A-B split test, ito yung pinaka-importante. Mostly, pinag-compare natin yung landing page. Landing page optimization is the process of improving web page design and layout with the goal of increasing conversion, elevating the user experience, and turning more visitors into loyal customers. So we will discuss here what are the elements for a high converting landing page. So ano ba yung mga elements na dapat meron ang landing page? So one, attractive headline. Number two, supporting subheadline, no? So makikita natin dito para sabay natin siya nakikita. Yung sa sample graphics dito. So usually makikita natin sa mga landing pages yung pinaka benefits or the pain points that a particular product or services are trying to solve. Yun ang nilalagay nila sa pain points eh. Or sometimes, kung ano yung pinaka-promo, yun ang nasa pain points. And then, the supporting sub-headline that support that attractive headline. So, ang kasunod dyan, meron dapat yung visual focus, headshot, video, etc. So, yung visual focus natin, make sure na relevant siya. Sometimes, video will capture attention, but it's case to case. Merong instances na just a static design can generate more conversion. So, malalaman lang natin yan upon doing A-B split test. Meaning, we will create 2 to 3 different landing pages with different mixture of elements that we have here. And then, based from the results that we can get, doon natin malalaman yan. Basically, sa mga landing page nga pala, guys, they can track that using UTM parameters. They will put UTM parameter installing in a particular landing page. So, natatrack natin kung saan ang gagaling yung traffic niyan. Diba, nung pinakita ko sa inyo, yung sa Google Analytics, kung saan yung traffic source nakikita, it's coming on social media, on Facebook, or a Google Ads campaign, or a blog page. Usually, nilalagyan ng UTM parameters yun para natatrack natin kung saan ang gagaling yung page source na yun. So, dito ganun din sa A-B split test natin. So, core benefits or solving pain points, yan. Dapat meron din yan. Before and after results. It will bring more convincing power to your landing page. So, nakikita yung before and after result. Trust and security. So, trust and security, ito yung may mga, sometimes yung mga website, nakikita natin, if you are an ISO certified, that is a big factor, no? Or if you are trusted by different agencies relevant to your niche. So, for example, if you're a marketing agency, you're offering services, then your target audience will see in your landing page or your website that you are Google certified, that you are Facebook certified, SEMrush certified, then it will increase the effect of conversion. So, customer and client testimonial. So, it brings more authority to your particular brand. Now, giving a client testimonials, putting that into your landing page or a website. So, scarcity. When we say scarcity, ito yung limited time offer na ilalagay natin like last up to 10 days. Or special edition. So, ito yung something na limited only. By putting this into your website, it helps to create more conversion then. So, meron din dito minsan, naglalagay tayo ng mga money back guarantee. So, just to make the impression that we will give to our end users or visitors that how safe it is na yung if they don't like the actual value, they can return it. Pero, literally, minsan, di naman talaga nila nagre-return. Wala naman ganun. Tinatambad na sila. So, it's just for the purpose of marketing, no? Na nilalagay nila yon. So, it adds a certain factor. So, clear CTA. Very important yan. So, ano ba yung gusto nating maging action nung end users natin? Is it to book for appointment? Is it to sign up? For example, if your landing page is for conducting a webinar, so ano yung goals nun? So dapat it is very clear. Or you want to have a certain specific product purchase. So dapat clear din siya. So, dito with AP speed test, nilalaro lang natin yan. Then based from the results, then kung ano yung mas mataas na conversion results, then yun ang gagamitin natin landing page. Again, in the following months, we will test again to make sure na ang conversion niya is consistent. Okay? Any question regarding this? Before we proceed with the next topic. Okay, we will proceed now to the next one. Psychology of conversion. Ito, daanan na natin to, no? What drives consumers to convert? Psychology of conversion. It's a well-known rule that people are more likely to take action when they feel a strong emotional connection to a particular product or service. This is why it's crucial to create campaigns that tap into the emotions of your target audience. By understanding the emotional motivators that drive consumer choices, you can create campaigns that resonate with your audience on a deeper level and ultimately drive more conversion. So nakita natin dito no, sa triangle, sa pyramid na to. So self-fulfillment, psychological needs, basic needs. So ito yung factors that drive for a better conversion rate, no? So as a CRO specialist, doesn't mean na may background ka as a psychology, but knowing this kind of triggers or factors will help a lot, will play an important part in conducting a CRO on your project or a particular website, no? So ano ba yung nagtitrigger? Bakit nagko-convert for a particular leads natin? So ano ang pinaka-importante dito is we know our target customers or the customer persona. So ito yon. The customer avatar, understanding your audience. What are customer avatars? A customer avatar, people call it your target audience or customer persona, is the detailed profile of your perfect potential customer. It focuses on a single fictional person instead of categorizing people into generalized groups. Companies that find the most success with their avatars understand that a customer wants desires, problems, and hangout all change over time. So, walang fix, no? Nagbabago over time. Yung customer avatars natin is gusto natin. Ganun din tayo. So, ito yung customer avatar. So, sa mga marketing specialist dito, sa mga social media manager, familiar sila dito sa ganitong terminology, customer avatar. So, knowing your customer avatar goals and values, your challenges and pain points, objections, and roles in purchase process will play an important part in conducting the 5 processes involved in the CRO. So it also helps the psychology of what converts a customers or your, you know. So the more that we know our target audience or customer avatars, mas nagiging concentrate or focus yung content natin sa kanila. So if our demographic target audience pa ay yung customer avatar ba natin is a professional, are they more on an outdoor person? So it plays an important role. So what is your ideal customer struggling with? So these are the questions, you know, but that very important to know your customer avatar. What are their goals and aspirations? Who are they? What influences their decisions? Where are they now? What is the next step for them? What are their jobs like? What are they excited about? What can your product, service do to transform their lives to a more desirable future state? So to number 8, pinakamahalaga yan. So connecting your product or service to your customer avatars based from understanding their psychological behaviors. So nalaman na natin what affects their decision, what are their pain points, then we can make our product or services resonates more with them, more relevant. The more relevant we connect to them, sabi nga natin kanina, the more they are to decide to convert into our desired goals or metrics. So let's give an example for our customer avatar. So John Matthews, age 47, marital status, married with 2 children, education, postgraduate. What motivates him? Work performance, focus, and family. So short biology biography. John is a CEO of an advertising agency and has a lot on his plate every day. As a chief executive, he has to keep himself alert during meetings and the decision-making processes. He understands that health is the most critical factor for his work performance. John is very health conscious and makes sure that he's physically fit and he finds time to exercise and eat healthy food. So health habits niya, he exercises regular, at least 30 minutes, strict diet plan and keeping dehydrated. So ito yung pain points niya. Missing the daily exercise slot because of a hectic schedule. Unable to adhere to healthy eating at parties and meetings. So if you are a business offering a services related to his problem, knowing what is the biography of John, his behavior, his likes, his motivation, then the more you can implement a more appropriate marketing approach that can connect with him. So, yun isa sa mga important factors na nagde-drive for a customer rate optimization with customer avatars. So, another one. So, si Tommy. So, ang background niya naman, staff accountant at founder accounting, completed his undergraduate degree state and his master's at Cornell University. Demographics, male, age 34. Annual income. So sometimes annual income is very important because we can determine if we will offer a premium services with them. Baka mamaya, we are trying to offer a high price to a low earning customer avatars. Does it make sense? No? Not unless in the near future, maging successful siya, ma-promote. So sometimes in marketing, they consider that. And then, habits and interests, running 5K races with his girlfriend, watching Game of Thrones. Biggest fears, getting stuck in a job, not advancing up in the corporate ladder as quickly as he'd like. So, common objections, I like the idea of a new website, but my boss will never go for it. He doesn't see the value in new technology. Okay. So, knowing these factors, medyo nakakaroon na tayo mas detailed idea about this customer avatar or customer persona. Then we can implement again the 5 principles of CRO. Okay. So, ito na. Ito na yung last topic natin. So, any question bago tayo mag-ano dito? So, some tools that we could use for CRO. Actually, there are a lot of tools. You know? So, because it involves a lot of department. For example, you need to be an SEO, or not to be an SEO, at least a background with SEO. So you need to know the tools that SEO use. If you are a UX UI, of course you should know what the UX UI specialist tools and other things, digital marketing, you should be a bit familiar with PPC or campaign ads. No? So dito, we will just mainly focus on the CRO tools that I think is very helpful when you want to start your career journey for this particular niche. Okay. Conversion optimization tool collects data about your website and its visitors to help you understand how people use your site and identify and test potential changes to increase conversion rates. So Google Analytics 4. So Google Analytics is the most popular web analytics tool installed on over 33 million websites. Google Analytics 4 helps you track traffic patterns, traffic sources, and goal conversion rates in real time. So, shortcut na natin to, no? Kasi masyado tayong mag-extend tayo sa oras. So, Google Analytics 4, it's free. You can create this one. You can explore it. So, madali siyang gamitin. Walang bayad yan. If you have a Google account, you can create, you could have access with a Google Analytics 4. No? Just make sure na meron tayong connected website dyan para makita natin yung mga data. There's a lot of tutorial that you can search on, like particular tutorial. And certification they also provide, no? Go to the actual Google Google website. So they are offering for free. So ito yung magiging pinaka best friend nyo. No? Even marketers, even SEO, no? Itong Google Analytics, napaka-useful niya. So another tool that I can recommend is the Hotjar. So Hotjar is a behavior analytics and conversion rate optimization suite that helps you measure and track user behavior and feedback. Tools like Hotjar, heat maps, and recording help you identify pain points of customer experiences on your site like website bugs, a confusing design, or broken links and elements. So itong Hotjar, ito yung may mga heat maps. Ito yung nare-record niya kung ano yung actual behavior. Ito yung sinasabi ko sa inyo kanina, tools na may capacity para makita yung actual user behavior natin. No? So, itong other tools then almost same lang din naman yan. So, Crazy Egg is a website heat maps and testing tools that helps you collect and evaluate visual data and test changes to your site. So, pare-parehas lang yan sila. It's just a matter of preference kung ano yung mas prepared mong gamitin. So, meron silang pros and cons din. Sometimes, it's just the subscription price ang nagbe-varies lang. Mas mahal yung isa. But with the functions, features, almost same lang din yan sila. Same with this one, Full Story. Full Story is an analytics tool for measuring digital interactions a user takes across multiple channels. Full Story offers heat maps, session recordings, and bug tracking, which will help your team identify buyers and improve user behavior on your website and mobile app. So almost same lang lahat yan. So what is a heat map? So just in case, kasi kanina pa natin siya nababanggit. Ano ba yung heat map? So just to give an idea for those that are not particularly aware or not familiar with what is a heat map. So heat maps are strong data visualization tool to discover what your users are doing when they're visiting your landing page. Heat map shows data that demonstrate the user's action throughout a website, homepage, and landing page. So, if gagamit kayo ng mga tools na nabanggit natin, Hotjar, Full Story, Crazy Egg, so lahat sila may mga ganito features yan. So, nakikita natin yung mga color na yan. Ito yung mga nag-triggers by user, web users. So, ito yung ano nila, behavior or actions. May kiniklik sila. No? So, makikita natin dito, itong may mga red, ito yung mga nakiklik na nila. So, makikita natin dito, halimbawa, itong e-shopper pre-commerce, e-commerce template, wala man lang nakiklik, wala man lang, di man lang na-hover ang mouse dyan. Meaning, we could improve it. So, wala siyang dati. Same with the images. So, it will help us to analyze anong part ba ng website natin or landing page ang kailangan ng improvements. This particular section ba, itong navigational section, itong hero banner section ba, CTA ba? So, lahat yan, natatrack yan through heat maps. So, heat maps, meron ding particular principles na sinusunod dyan. But just to give you the summary and how to, and understanding of what heat maps do terms of CRO. No? So, ito. Ayan. Nakikita natin. So, with those tool, may heat maps na, may recording pa tayo. So, super guaranteed tayo na reliable yung data na makukuha natin. So, a heat maps using this tool combination with Google Analytics will give us the overall impressions, the overall data that we need for us to create a better conversion rate strategy and approach to our projects or websites. So, madalas, naririnig natin to sa mga ibang mga business owners, no? Ayaw na nila ng website. They commonly marinig na sa nila, websites are dead. No? It's not essential anymore. Di na natin kailangan yan. It is because they did not apply a good CRO strategy on a particular website. So, kahit anong website meron ka, it hindi naman siya under ICRO principle, then talagang useless lang din ang website mo. No? So, website is not dead. Website is useful kapag na-implement natin itong CRO na to. So, that's it, guys. Again, thank you for joining this webinar. Please let me know if you have any questions. Okay.
Ayan. Ayan. Thank you, Sir Jeff, para sa isang napaka-siksik na learning.
Yes.
Thank you,
so ngayon,
Max.
Guys, bigyan naman natin ng... Ayan, binibigyan ka na ng palakpakan ng mga audience natin, sir. Sasabihin ko pa naman sana, bigyan ka ng heart and thumbs up. Ayan, dami, sir. Oh. So marami ba kayo natutunan, guys? Dami, oh.
So, Q&A.
So, Q&A na tayo, sir.
Okay,
ang dami, sige. Madami-dami to. Tutulungan ka namin magbasa, sir. Huwag kang mag-alala.
Oh, sige, sige.
Go on, guys. Type in your questions for Sir Jeff sa
Which is the most, the best among those po? So, in terms of tools nga, sabi ko, it's just a matter of preference. So, almost preparees lang yan. All, lahat yan sila user-friendly. For my personal preference, Hotjar ako. Kasi doon ako nag-start. So, kasi mas pioneering lang sila. Matagal na yung Hotjar. So, yun ang ginagamit ko. But other tools like Crazy Egg, Cool Store are good. Marami rin dyan, lumalabas pa. Especially right now, we are on AI advancement na. So, mas maraming technology ang nagagamit dyan. Na in terms of CRO, in terms of marketing, napakarami. So, hindi lang itong nilis ko. Ito lang yung preference ko. No? So, ano pa yung mga ano natin?
Ito, sir,
yes.
Question.
How about Microsoft Clarity? Yes, Microsoft Clarity. It's free. So, almost same features din siya, no, na may ma-implement natin sa website natin. Yun ang kagandahan niya. It's under Microsoft. So, it's free lang yan, guys. So, kung gusto nyo mag-try, I would suggest to try Microsoft Clarity. Yes. It's correct. Microsoft Clarity. In the absence of website, is it possible paid LinkedIn a better alternative for landing page? Depending on your niche, isa kasi talagang if you're a corporate businesses, no, it is essential to have a website, a high converting website. Kasi nalaman natin dito eh, we could install different plugins, we could install different features that can help us to track activities of a user's behavior. So, yung iba kasi nasanay na lang sa Facebook eh. Okay na ako sa social media. Di ba? Tingnan natin yung nangyaring ano, blackout ng Facebook. Nataranta lahat ng mga business. Kasi, merong minsan, 1 million followers na yung page nila. Biglang nag-blackout. Saan ka kayo kukuha ng leads mo? Di ba? Kung minsan yung website ay yung Facebook page ang nangyari, naging problem dyan. Nag-run ng ad campaign na ban. Wala ka na nagawa. Meron 200,000 followers yan. Diba? So, nawala na yung in-invest mo doon. Unlike website, meron kang overall control dyan. And in terms of conversion rate, guys, the number of highest conversion rate coming from organic search. So, makikita natin yan. Hindi sa... We tested before for a client. It's a beauty product. So, one of the most famous brand here in the Philippines. So, hindi ko nabanggitin. Kasi, ano siya, client namin siya. No? So, we implemented some testing with their website because they have almost, I think, 800,000 followers in their Instagram. 1 million followers in their Facebook. And then, we track saan nang gagaling ang highest conversion sales nila. Then, nagulat sila. It's more on organic. So, galing sa SEO, yung highest conversion. Social media helps you for your authority, for your awareness. But actual conversion, sometimes, it's more on organic. So, more question, guys.
Ito, sir, from Alan Byong. Sir Jeff, what is the typical day for a CRO specialist?
More on data. So, yon, keep reading the data. So, day to day, basaan ang basa ng data. Keep on experimenting. More on testing. So, yon, ano yan. Try learning different areas in marketing. Kasi lahat yan sakop niya. Sabi ko nga, it's not just on a website. It's on a holistic approach. It can be on Facebook ads. It can be on Google ads. It can be on SEO, it can be on the design. So everything is a vital part for an CRO process. Okay. Thank you for that, Alan. So, which is the most useful and easy to understand? Is it CRO, UXUI, or SEO? So, based dito sa diniscuss ko nga, no? Yung UXUI focuses more on the design, user behavior. Mas malawak din siyang scope. SEO is different. But CRO combines everything. So, the more you're skilled with SEO, the more you're skilled with UXUI, the more you become a better CRO. So, mas malawak siya, mas malaki. So, that's why mapapansin nyo, hindi siya common na tinuturo. Kasi parang mostly people, mostly online, people are aware with SEO. Most of them are aware with UXUI now. But with CRO, they are not aware. So, it's a holistic approach. No? Okay. Thank you for that, Madison. What advice can you give po for beginners? Keep learning, you know, just keep learning every day, you know. So, read, manood ng mga tutorials, keep attending this kind of webinar, especially, we should be very thankful with this kind of company, organization like BAME, no? Offering this kind of pre-webinars, conducting this kind of pre-webinars. They invest in your education. So, maganda yung mga ganito. Keep joining this kind of webinars. So, yun ang may papayo ko, may advice ko. So, I am my chief office admin po. Pwede mo ba itong system nyo? Pero di po siya market track. Purely admin and finance. Basically, when we say CRO kasi, it's more on conversion. So, conversion closely related with marketing yan eh. So, we can track, we will help the overall business to get a better conversion. Either 5%, 10%. Imagine a 10% conversion rate is not bad, you know, for start lot. Imagine you have a 100,000 website visitors. Just get at least 10%. So it's around 10,000. So you have 10,000 who purchase your product or monthly subscription of 50. So multiply that. So napakataas niya. So just 10%, no? So I'm not sure how we can apply it in internal admin, but it's more on the actual sales. It's more on actual marketing. Eventually, how and how much do you charge as a CRO? Okay, this is a good question. Yeah. So for everyone here that joining this webinar, it's a good career path for you guys. Kasi it pays a lot. No? Become a CRO specialist. Kasi you give actual value to the business. Diba? No business will not spend a good amount pag nalaman nila na you can bring a substantial results for their business. Diba? Parang conversion na yung binibigay mo eh. So, they pay a lot. Sometimes in the USA, USA mga client doon, basically, ang mga CRO, they are getting some cut or commission. For example, e-commerce. So, they will get at least 10%. So, aside from the standard pay. So, napakaganda yung career path. So, charge, it will depend on your expertise and level. So, it will, sometimes, it start like at least like 3,000 USD to more and more. Depending, you can check online na lang, no?
Paano po namin? Na agad yun sa peso, sir.
Grabe.
Oo, malaki siya talaga. Ito, this is a good question from anonymous attendee. Paano po namin na-encourage ang client sa idea sa website para sa kanila ng business? Kukula pa silang website, particularly in local businesses. Well, this is the challenges that most of the marketing agencies that we have right now, especially kami as a marketing agency. By the way, ako ay isang owner ng web development and full digital service marketing agency din. So, ito yung usual na nakita namin response ng mga client. They don't need a website. Kaya hanishare ko sa inyo eh. They don't need a website. They have this kind of social media. But showing them the data that we have, no, yung problems na pwede na ma-encounter without having website, na having a website, having a full control, you know, like you can track, you can retarget them, you can create retention, you can create a lead nurturing marketing with them. Mas naiintindihan nila to, mas naiintindihan nila tong CRO, they are eager to invest, no? So, okay.
Sa tanong lang dun sa ano sir, sa dagdag lang sa local
sure.
business. Sa tingin niyo ba sir, yung local business dito sa Philippines, talagang magagamit ba talaga yung website niya? Compared
yes.
sa US, compared sa ibang
Actually, minsan dito sa atin, even without CRO, just a local SEO lang, ha? Just a local SEO will help a lot because it will give you awareness. Eh. Sabi nga nila, if your presence not online, and then they will look for your competitors. Eh, ang presence mo is more on social media. In social media, lahat kayo dyan, sabay-sabay. What makes you different with them? Unlike your website, it's your branding. Eh. Parang it puts you authority na, automatic, di ba? So, it gives a good impression, you know, like having a website. Di naman yung mga price na may mga website dito, automatic nagtataas. Kasi may website sila. It gives you the feeling that they are premium.
Premium, yeah. Correct.
Having a website, di ba? But somehow, sometimes, the problem here is, for the sake of having a website, yung iba, nag-take lang sila na, basta magkaroon ako ng website, okay na yan. So, marami dito nag-offer 15,000 pesos for a website. May website ako. And then later on, yung website nila ang bagal. Yung website nila, daming problema. Instead, makatulong na makakonvert sa mga target leads nila, naging disadvantage pa. Kasi nangyari, it keeps a bad reputation. Sa website na lang, di makapag-invest yan. Paano pa kaya yung services niya? Di ba? Yun ang sinasabi ko sa mga local businesses dito, di ba? So, if you are capable, it's a long-term investment. Your website sa'yo yan. So, it's very important.
Yeah. Thank you, sir.
Okay. This is a good question din, no? CRO versus PPC, which is better? No, hindi sila parehas. We cannot say CRO versus PPC. PPC, CRO helps PPC. No, conversion rate optimization. I-analyze mo kung bakit yung PPC mo hindi ganun kataas ang results. Google Ads or Facebook Ads, baka may problem yung ad creatives mo. Baka may problem yung targeting mo ng demographics, your targeting your audience are different. So, different metrics ang ginagamit mo. So, CRO oversee everything. So, it helps your PPC campaign, no? Okay. CRO is also marketing like panels. Panels is under CRO, no? So, panels from top, middle, bottom panels, no? So, under ng CRO yan. With the CRO process implemented with the panels, it helps you more. No? Paano ka mag-create ng awareness? Paano ka mag-create ng engagement until the actual bottom of the panel? Which lead with which conversions? Diba? So, hi, Sir Jeff. Can I apply as an intern? So, si Bame ang bahala sa inyo. So, yan. Bame will help you to get a client, no? You're in good hands, guys. So, okay. Ano nga po? Ano po mga CRO meets na dapat iwasan? CRO meets, so, instant results, no? Like, if any company, same with SEO, if an SEO specialist will tell you, I will give you results, I will rank your page in the first month, then run. Kasi walang assurance, kahit gaano ko galing yan. Maybe they have the variables, they have the standard approach, the metrics, but at the end of the day, walang assurance yan. Same with CRO, no? CRO has the highest probabilities na will give you a highest conversion. Hindi mo lang pwedeng sabihin kung ilan. You cannot say like, I will give you 100% conversion rate. But there are instances that it happens. 50%, 100%. Pag nagbigay ka ng 50%, hindi ka na ibibitawan ng client mo. Yan, mahal na mahal. So, yun.
How about the time frame, sir? Meron kang time frame for, halimbawa?
Good question. Yes. So, because of the crucial process involves in a CRO, like, stage by stage, eh, di ba? Sometimes, it will take up to 3 months. You know, minimum 3 months to get the actual results. First month yan, we will check on the data. Diba? Lahat ng data yan. Tapos magkakaroon tayo ng A-B split test. Ito try natin, i-launch yung panibagong landing page or panibagong design ng page. Same with PPC, i-implement din natin yung changes doon. So in totality, mag-a-adjust tayo sa campaign, mag-a-adjust tayo ng content, ng copy, mag-a-adjust tayo ng design. So imagine how much time it needs para magawa lahat yun. And then, stage by stage, makikita natin yung mga metrics na tinatrack natin, then we can get the actual results that we want.
Ayan. Tama, sir. So, 3 months ang pinaka parang
ideally,
time frame.
Ideally, makikita natin. So, the more, kasi ano yan parang sa ngayon kasi AI na tayo, parang ang gagaling na parang yung mga machine learning natin, mas accurate na. So, nakakatulong yan ngayon. So, yun, medyo accurate siya. It helps and saves time, no, for testing sometimes. So, yun, nalilis yung AP split test natin.
Minsan din naman, sir, depende yan. Kung halimbawa, talagang bagong-bago pa lang si client. Siyempre, need pa yan mag-collect ng data, di ba, para makapag-optimize ka na mas magandang.
Kaya nga, I suggest business owner, simulan mo na. Kasi sa amin sinasabi minsan ng mga business owners na okay naman ang business ko, even without websites. Just imagine if you will have a website.
Yeah,
diba?
Correct.
Di ba? Kasi, check your competitors. If your competitors, lahat kayo, for example, no, lahat yung competitors mo, wala kayong website. Kung may website ka, may advantage ka na kagad eh. Kasi local SEO pa lang makikita ka na eh. Halimbawa, local gym, gym near me. Lalabas yun eh. Kung merong SEO specialist kang inapay, wala pang CRO to ha. SEO pa lang. So, malaking factor na yun eh. So, ang CRO, papasok na yan kapag nakikita mo ang daming visitors na sa website mo. Pero wala nagko-convert, wala nagpapabook ng appointment. So, dyan na papasok si CRO. Bakit? Ba't hindi nagko-convert? Anong problema? So, yun na yun. Can we do this without SEO experience? It's a holistic eh. So, kailangan talaga, if we want to become effective, kasi nilaktawan mo si SEO, ang problema pala is nasa mga keywords. So, paano siya magiging effective kung ang problema is nasa keywords? Yung sinasabi ko kanina, yung mga nilagay na keywords pala doon sa website or sa landing page, yung user search intent nun, wala palang yung customer avatar pala nun, hindi naman pala premium, walang capacity to pay. So, tinatarget mo siya, hindi talaga magkakaroon ng conversion. So, the better you know SEO, the right keywords, the better conversion rate you can provide to your client. Okay,
so guys, yung CRO, parang ang daming under niya eh. Kumbaga, CRO, dapat may idea ka sa lahat ng ano eh.
Yes.
Sa lahat ng branches niya. Mapa ad creatives, ganun. Creatives na gagamitin mo.
Yes.
Sa copy.
Correct, tama. Oh, UX UI, diba yun niya? Yung may advantage kayo. You have an advantage, you know? So ganyan. Which is more related to CRO? Is it data analysis or data analytics? Both yan. As long as data related, no? So, yun. Hello po.
So,
what
guys,
are
question
the...
pa.
Okay na.
Hindi po, sir.
go ahead po. Hindi ako rin kung may question pa. Any more question, guys?
Question pa.
Okay, mo. Okay na sila. Mukhang naintindihan. Si CRO, no?
Siguro ba, pag numbers, sir, nalilito na eh.
Oh, medyo...
More on numbers kayo, sir, di ba? Parang everyday, more on numbers ang kaharap nyo eh.
May numbers din siya kasi, kinukompute mo yung formula, yung conversion rate, yung CPC. Di naman super technical, but may idea ka lang, pag araw-araw mo siyang ginagawa, masasanay ka na eh. Okay, ganito pala yung results niya. Ganito lang yung bounce rate niya. Ganito pala yun. So, paano ba yung gagawin natin? So, magkocontact ka na yan. So, hawak mo yung team. Halimbawa, mga developers. Misa, mabagal yung website. Kaya pala, hindi nagko-convert. Napakabagal. Or, hindi responsive yung website na ginawa. Pagdating sa mobile, ang pangit. Nang ano, minsan, yung simple buttons lang. Alam nyo ba sa website, minsan sa mobile, people don't understand the hamburger button. Are you familiar with the hamburger button sa mobile? Yung maliit lang. Yung menu. They don't know. Parang tiyatanong ako. I have a client. Tiyatanong sa akin, asan yung other pages? Sabi ko, dyan po sa hamburger button. What's hamburger? Siyempre, hindi naman nila alam yun. Di ba? Hindi naman sila thinking people. So, hindi nila mahanap yun na pwede pa i-click yun. So, sometimes, just putting the word menu, they understand. They can click on that. So, small changes, big impact sa CRO yan. Minsan akala natin wala. Just a simple button, minsan super powerful yan. So, ganon ang CRO. Yes, the power of analytics din talaga, correct. It's more on data. Is there an indicator that you can say that the website? Oo, madali-madali mo na malalang cash. Hindi mo na siya itrack eh. So, may kita mo na pag inabot siya ng mga almost 30 seconds loading, mabagal na yan. Dapat in 2 to 5 seconds naglo-load na ang page. Pag hindi, lalayasan ka na ng mga web users mo niyan. Hindi siya optimized. So, big pack, number one factor yon. Pag alis ni website visitors mo, punta agad sa competitors mo yan. So, nawala na sa'yo. So, yon. Any more question, guys?
So, yon guys. Question pa kay sir. Habang nandito pa si sir.
Ito parang may tanong na hindi nasagot. Not sure po ah, pero from Ken, ask ko lang po regarding sa tools. Meron po ba kayong natitipuhang AI tools na related sa CRO?
AI tools, mostly SEO-related tools eh, tsaka yung mga data ang ginagamit ko, yung sa mga apps mo. Maraming tools, if I will tell you one by one kasi napakadaming these. In a marketing agency, I used to work with a marketing agency and we are a marketing agency. Minimum na ang 20 softwares that we are using. Ganon karami.
Ang dami.
Oo. Yes, to make sure that successful yung campaign.
Alright, commercial lang. Na-send na po sa chat box ang ating form para sa attendance. So, mag-raise lang ng hand sa mga hindi makaka-register and then bibigyan ko kayo kung anong magandang gawin or suggestion dyan. Okay? So, ang pagsisend po ng ating certificate within like midweek. Okay? So, pa-check nyo lang ang spam baka doon napunta at hindi dumarek sa inyong inbox. Okay? Yan lang po.
Okay. So, ito. I think question pa. Last question siguro to?
Yes, sir.
Okay, okay. Usually, magkano ang price ng isang website? With SEO, CRO, landing page, email marketing sa Pilipinas, magkano po ang pwede charge? Ako, sky is the limit yan. Depende yan sa target client mo, if capable ba. But yan kasi, it requires more skill, it requires more people, it requires more tool. So, website, you can charge here in the Philippines. May nag-offer, may nakita ako. Which is sadly, I don't know how they can offer that. Siguro mga startup pa lang, 3,000. Hindi ko alam kung paano itsura ng website nun. But ideally, a good website, yeah, start siya mga 75,000. Maganda na yan. So, meron na yan, ano na yan, fully customized na yung website na yan. So, ginamitan na ng standard CRO practices yan. With SEO, different charge yan. So, after the website is done, tsaka lang i-implement ang SEO. And then, of course, CRO, kasi may data na siya, ongoing yan. Same with the landing page and email marketing.
Ayun.
So, yun.
Take note, guys.
So, ayun, sir. Baka meron kang gustong yan, sir, i-promote or i-plug yeah. About sa business mo, sir.
Ayun. If ever lang na-need nyo ng marketing services, web development, gumagawa kami din ng website. We offer web application, mobile app application. Gumagawa rin kami yan. So, the company focus on marketing, of course, as a CRO specialist. So, lahat yan. Saklaw namin yan. PPC, social media. Budget will depend on the niche. Meron naman tayong mga different packages that we can offer. And siguro, I can provide here for website. Ito ha, sa lahat ng mga nag-join dito. Baka may kilala kayo. Ngayon lang, anong gamit tayo ng promo code? So, BAME ang promo code gagamitin natin. Pag nag-inquire kayo, I will give 50% off sa website natin.
Wow.
50%. 50%. And flexible 3 payment terms. Yan ha.
Grabe.
Flexible. So, yan.
Sa mga startup so, business dyan, go.
Oh, okay. Gamitin natin yung ang coupon code natin. BAME CRO, yan. Gamitin natin pa nag-inquire kayo sa amin. So, you can visit our website, www.blurmediapro.com. Yan. Yun yung website namin. So, yan. If ever kailangan nyo ng website, web application, mobile apps, SEO, holistic approach CRO, yan. We will provide. So, lahat, bigyan natin ng ano yan. Ng discount sa mga nag-join dito sa ano natin. Baka may kilala kayo, I can give you discount. Yan.
Oh, ayan na. Pinent na ang ano, ang email, ang
website.
Website ni sir dito sa ating chat.
Ayun.
Grabe.
So ayun guys, ganun kayo kalakas kay Vame kasi isang business owner pa. ng isang digital marketing, ay, ng isang, yeah, CRO ang nag-talk sa atin. So, yon. Miss Bless, meron ko po bang i-promote sa ating mga social accounts?
I'm inviting everyone to please like and follow us on our socials. So, we have Facebook, Instagram, TikTok, and YouTube. So, guys, i-like nyo kami dyan sa socials. We will send it here sa ating chat. Ayan, nakasend na yan. Ayan, nakasend na pala. Thank you, ma'am. So, please like and follow us para updated kayo sa mga ganitong events and, you know, mga free webinars.
Kasi, tapos ma'am, di ba makikita na yung replays sa ating YouTube?
Yes. Every Wednesday, we post the replay po ng ating webinar para sa mga hindi naka-attend and at the same time sa mga nahihirapan sa signal minsan kasi paputol-putol, di ba? So, ayan. I-watch ganyan.
Sa mga hindi nagiging successful sa pag-fill out ng form, ang maganda na yung gawin, mag-screenshot kayo na nandito kayo right now na naka-attend kayo sa webinar. Send niyo, punta kayo sa FB page namin, send kayo ng message, send yung screenshot, full name and email. Para legit, wala na kaming tatanungin kung nag-attend ba kayo or yung iba nagsisend lang for attendance. Okay? So, send lang kayo ng message ngayon, screenshot nyo na andito kayo ngayon sa webinar namin. Okay? So, yun, mag-promote na po tayo para magkaroon tayo ng picture taking.
Guys, bigyan muna natin ng isa pang palakpakan si Sir Jeff.
Thank you again, guys. Thank you for this opportunity, babe. Good luck sa inyo, no? Sa mga aspiring BA dito. Good luck.
Okay. Picture taking muna tayo. Pasok kayo, guys. Pinapromote po natin sila na mag-join sa ating panel at magpipicture taking tayo.
Ayun.
And then open ang camera.
Sa mga nalalo ng GCash, ma'am, I believe na ipasa na sa kanila, no?
Yes, naipadala na po sa inyo. So,
anong kabilis? Parang LBC, ma'am, ah.
Pari ng padala, nag-promote. Alright, wait lang. Madami sila. 300 plus to, sir.
Dami, grabe.
Thank you, guys.
Updates or announcements, punta lang po kayo sa mga social media namin. Doon po kami nag-update. Okay? Thank you so much, everyone! Salamat po, Sir Jeff, sa inyong pag-cooperate, pag-share ng experience and knowledge. Thank you! Bye-bye!